I just want you to do me a huge favor, because this is a serious moment for me. And what makes this moment serious for me is that I'm sitting in a room of people who have the ability to make their dreams become a reality. And we live at a time and live in a country where we can make that dream a reality. And you have to understand that there are times that I speak, for instance, in prisons. And I'm talking to individuals who will spend the rest of their lives in prison, and they don't have options. They don't have a lot of choice. That what I do when I come in is I provide a sense of hope, and I provide some inspiration, but I'm not able to help them to bring about the change that they want to see happen. And I'm so excited to be in this room, because the words that I say in this moment can fuel the rest of your life. Right, so I'm so excited. Like, for me, this isn't I won't ask you for anything over the next hour other than the things that are gonna take you to the next level. But I'm excited because when I leave, we may never see each other again, but I have the ability, when you walk out of this room, to make you operate in a way you've never operated before. And once you do that, because I know if you're in this room, I know there's something special about you, that once you leave this room and you go from 70 to 120%, there are gonna be some things that happen in your life that didn't happen before, not because you didn't have the ability. So this is not an ability room. Like, we're not talking about ability. We're talking about activating this greatness that's in us. Your abilities are your abilities. I'm not gonna be able to help you to do anything that you do better. Like, I'm not gonna be able to give you a gift that you don't have. But what I will be able to do is help you today operate in a way you've never operated before. Right? I will help you to operate in a way you've never operated before. I'm gonna help you to do some things that you've never done in your life before. And as a result, you're gonna be able to go to a whole new level. So we have to start here. Just write down those things, one or two or three things that you have to desperately get done before this year ends. It's desperation. I don't have a choice. I don't have an option. You got to get that done. Got it. Like, I just want you. And I'm not talking about stuff that's kind of important. I'm talking about the stuff that has got it. The ball's dropping and you can't keep talking about it. Like, you will not be able to rest if you didn't get this done. I want you to write that down. That's where we're starting. I want you to write that down. E.T., like, I got to get this done, E. Like, E, this is no option. This is not like a vacation. This is not, you know, just making a couple more dollars for the sake of buying a car, a house. Like, E, this is some life and death stuff, E. Like, this is some change the trajectory of my life stuff, E. This is like, it's gonna put me in a place like where I'm just gonna be able to get to that place that I've been trying to get to. I want you to write that down. And it was, look guys, I'm being honest. It was like random. It was like just totally random. It was out of nowhere. It was the Christmas holiday, and Carl, our videographer, had his family over, and we live around, at that time, we lived around the corner from each other. Now we live on the same block. Random, right? Christmas was over. We're just going to the house, just eating dinner. It just was a random night. And somehow we got to talking, and Carl's wife is from Barbados, and she didn't have citizenship. So unfortunately, she was in the States without citizenship, and so she had to stay in school in order to eventually get her citizenship. So she did her master's degree, you know, and she was in her PhD, and it was weird. It was just like, yo, E.T., I don't know how it happened, but it was like, yo, E.T., my wife is gonna get her degree before you get yours, right? I'm an American citizen. Like, I had already been in the program for a few years, and, you know, I don't know, but have you ever heard, like, you know when it's your time? Like, you know it's that moment. It's like, enough is enough. I can't tell you. People have asked me before, Eric, when you get your PhD? I'm like, I'll get it done. E.T., how far are you in the process? Finish all my coursework. I just got to write the dissertation. But it was something about that night that was different. It was almost the end of the year. And I remember Carl, listen to me very closely, guys. I'm being real with you. I didn't even have a conversation with Carl. Like, we never even talked about it afterwards. I never said anything to him about it. But I felt this guilt. I felt like this embarrassment. Like, and for real, he wasn't like speaking directly to me. He was just saying, you know, hey, E, I think my wife's probably gonna finish her degree before you finish yours. And I'm talking about like it pierced. And I just remember like we were talking afterwards and I didn't hear anything. Like, bro, have you ever been in a conversation and it just shifts and somebody's talking to you and like you can't hear the words that are coming out of their mouth? I didn't hear anything he said. I just kept it like, E, when are you gonna get this done, E? Like, yo, E, are you ever going to finish this? And it's not about a degree, but are you ever going to finish this? Like, are you going to get it done? And I remember excusing myself, like, all right, Carl, hey, great time. Love you guys. Gotta go. Gotta get up in the morning. And I'm telling you guys, it's not even a 5-minute walk, and it felt like an hour. All I could think about when I was going home was like, enough is enough. Like, I'm through. I'm gonna get this done. Okay, just help me out. You're in the room. You ever had that enough is enough moment? Raise your hand for me. You had that enough is enough moment, right? So I need you to be there. Like the next 30, 40 minutes, I need you in that space. That enough is enough. I'm not dumb. Like I can get a PhD. Has nothing to do with that. It has everything to do with the fact that I just didn't say, all right, this is the year. Right? And so that thing you wrote down, I need you to do me a huge favor. I don't know if you have a pen or a piece of paper. I don't even know if you can do this on your phone, but I want you to kind of put a year next to that for me. Put a year. I want you to just put a year on that for me. Like, don't make up, like, don't do it for me. Get a real number. Just give me like a real, real solid number, right? And I remember saying to myself, like, yo, if we come back next year for Christmas and your family's here, I remember saying to myself, we come back this time next year, I'm gonna be Dr. Thomas. We come back to your house next year. As a matter of fact, I will pay for your parents to come. Like, I wanna reinvent this whole like scenario again next year. Like, I want everybody here. Let's do the same meal. Let's sing the same songs. Let's Twilight Zone this thing out. I want it to be exactly like it was, except for this time, I want you to say Dr. Thomas. Like, this is going on in my mind. I'm not having a conversation with anybody. And I'm saying like, this is it, guys. This is it. And so I put a date on it. I put a date. I said 2015, we're not gonna have this conversation. 2015 is time next year. I'm finished, it's done, right? Good, so now I need you to do me a favor. I need you to put a month next to it. Yeah, I need you to put a month next to it now. You got January all the way to December. I need you to put a month on it for me. Give me a month. Yeah, I need you to put a month on it for me, right? Right now, as you're writing the month down, what I want you to think about is, okay, so write this down too. I'm sorry. I know you came to listen, not do a lot of writing. I apologize, but I really need this. I really need this. I really need this. I really need this. I need you to write down three people you love next to those goals. Three people you love. Just three people. Right? Give me the name. Write the names down. I don't put son, mom, or give it to me. Give it to me. Give it to me. Give it to me. Right? Write their names down. Now, this is what I need you to think about. What I need you to think about is how this goal or these goals will revolutionize their lives. Like, I really want you to think about, okay, you can do this later. When you get home, you can do this later, but I want you to write down for each one of them, give me three ways. Please do this when you get home. If you really love them, like you say you love them, when you get home, I need you to write their names down, and I need you to write down when you get to this place, when you finally make this thing happen, how is it going to empower them? How is it going to change their life? And all I can think about is, wow, if I get this PhD, like I can just like change the zeros. Like, I just remember thinking, like, there were doors that were closed to me in the United States of America, right? Because of the nationality that I come from or the part of town that I come from. And I specifically remember people picking other people over me for speaking engagements that weren't as good as I was. I remember people using the excuse of you're not qualified enough. And I remember the PhD, we're gonna solve all of that. Like, no more ET ain't qualified. No more, like, we're gonna pick this bird over this bird. Like, nope. This PhD is going to open doors for me that were once closed, which means it's gonna open doors for my daughter, which means it's gonna open doors for my wife, which means it's gonna open doors for my mother, which means it's gonna open doors for CJ, which means it's gonna open doors for Carl. And so every day when I woke up, I remembered the people that this degree would affect. And so the days I did not feel like studying, the days I did not feel like writing, the days I wanted to sleep on the plane, I thought about CJ and his family. I thought about Carl and his family. And I said, E.T., keep going. Listen to me very closely. The reason why you stop and start, and you stop and you start, and you stop and you start, is because the goal is not meaningful enough. There's something about the goal that if you quit, it's not gonna hurt nobody. If you quit, it's not gonna change nothing. If you quit, it's not that deep. Look, this is what I need you to do. So immediately when I left that house and I made up in my mind that I was going to get the PhD, I remember immediately doing a TGIM saying, all right, it's over. It's over. A year from now, I will be Dr. Thomas. And I just didn't speak it into the atmosphere. I spoke it to people who would hold me accountable. Write it down. Write it down. Who's gonna hold you accountable? Who's gonna hold you accountable? Who's that person? Who's that person? And some of you have been a part of the real estate program. Some of you just come to hear me. When you leave, I need you to call that person, that guy, that young lady, that mother or that father. Like, I need you to call that person and say, yo, I got to do these three things before this month and before, yep. And this is who I'm doing it for. And this is why. So just somebody real quick over here, because we gotta make this real. Somebody over here real quick, we gotta make this real. Somebody tell me who's that person you're calling over here. Who's that person you're calling? Who's that person that on this side, that person who's gonna hold you accountable? Who's that person? You've identified that person. I need you to raise your hand for me. Tell me who that person is. Yes, sir, who's that person? Good, good. Look, I need you to hear me. Here's the last step and we're moving forward. The last step is I need you to identify that person. And I identified that person. After I went on YouTube and said, hey, guys, I'm marching. May, matter of fact, I turned it into an event. Listen to me very closely. I rented out a space. I put the deposit down. I tasted the food. Like, we did a tasting. I decided what food we were going to eat. The linen. We had to decide what linen. This is 8 months before I even graduated. Never forget, one of the professors came to me and said, E.T., there's a lot of paperwork to fill out. We got about 2 or 3 months left, but I'm just going to be honest with you. You waited on some things because you weren't in school, and now you're back, but I just don't think you're going to be able to make it happen. And I laughed. I chuckled. She said, no, I'm serious. There's a format, and there's a way, and there's some, and you didn't, and it takes this month for this long, 30 days for this, 6 weeks for that, and you just didn't put your paperwork in time. And I said, ma'am, I'm sorry, but you don't get it. I called my grandma and told my grandma I was graduating. Like, no, I'm being serious. Like, I called my grandma, and my grandma said, baby, you know I'm on a fixed income. So if I buy this ticket, grandma can't get her money back. I said, ma'am, I told my grandma that I was graduating, and my grandma already called her hairstylist and told her how she wanted her hair to look. Grandma went out and bought a dress. My grandma bought a dress for the graduation. And you got to hear what I'm saying, because you're listening to me, but you're not listening to me. Listen to what I'm trying to tell y'all. I'm being real with y'all. My biological father wasn't in my life. Hear what I'm saying. My mother hid from me who my biological father was, yet my grandmother's always been in my life. That don't go together. My grandmother said to my mother, if you want to hide the identity of his father, that's cool, but you can't take my grandson from me. And so ever since I've been a kid, my grandma been to everything. She's never missed anything. And when my grandma called, she said, you better make sure you graduate, baby, because I'm coming. And so what I'm trying to tell you is, I didn't get the degree to get the degree. I got the degree because I called my grandma. I'm trying to tell you the reason why you're not doing it is not because you don't have what it takes to do it. Not because you don't have the ability to do it. But whatever it is you say you're going to do, the meaning is not strong enough. Somehow the meaning is not strong enough. You've not put enough value in it. You don't have enough skin in it. You played around with it so much that you don't have nothing to lose if you don't do it. What I'm telling you is, you got to create the type of scenarios, not the goal, the type of scenarios that if it doesn't work, you lose everything. And because you cannot lose everything, you got to make it happen. Glenn came all the way from Australia. You can't plan your graduation in 2 weeks. You can't buy a ticket from Australia and then call somebody and say, Glenn, it's not going to happen now. Was that a refundable? Did you get a refundable ticket? So I need you to put some value, because if you put 120% value in it, 120% meaning in it, and you get 120% accountability on it, every single goal you write down is going to happen.